The first question that we are going to deal with is solve dou cubed z by dou x square dou y plus 18xy square plus sine 2x minus y equal to 0. As you can see, this is a third order first degree partial differential equation. The procedure is direct integration method. So we will be integrating this partial differential equation twice with respect to x and once with respect to y. And in the end, we will be getting z as a solution, as a function of x and y. Solution. We are going to integrate the given partial differential equation twice with respect to x. In each of these integrations, since we are integrating with respect to x, we keep y as a constant. Y is kept as a constant temporarily. So we keep y temporarily as a constant, keeping y temporarily as a constant. Now let us see what happens after the first integration with respect to x. It becomes dou square z by dou x dou y plus 18 y square is a constant into x square by 2 plus integral of sine is minus cos 2x minus y divided by 2, that is equal to, in this indefinite integral there will be a constant of integration. That constant of integration can either be a plain constant or a function of y. So here let me put it as f of y. Now let me simplify this expression. So dou square z by dou x dou y plus 9 x square y square minus 1 by 2 cos 2x minus y equal to f of y. Now the next is again integration with respect to x. The next step is also integration with respect to x. So in the next integration, after the next integration with respect to x, we will be having dou z by dou y. Again we keep y as a constant, so 9y square is a constant, into x square, integral of x square is x cubed by 3, minus 1 by 2 integral of cos is sine 2x minus y into 1 by 2 equal to fy into integral dx, so that is x fy plus another constant of integration. Let me put that constant of integration as g1. So let us simplify this. Dou z by dou y plus 3x cubed y square minus 1 by 4 sine 2x minus y equal to x fy plus g1. So first two integrations with respect to x is over. Now then the next step we shall integrate. Next step is integration with respect to y. And we know in this procedure, x is kept as a constant. So in this next integration, x is kept as a constant. So let us see what happens after the next integration. So integral dou z by dou y with respect to y is z plus 3x cubed is a constant. Integral y square is y cubed by 3 minus 1 by 4 into integral sine is minus cos 2x minus y into minus 1 equal to x integral fy dy plus integral gy dy plus, there is one more constant of integration. Let me put the next constant of integration as wx. So let us simplify the whole expression. It is z plus x cubed y cubed minus 1 by 4 cos 2x minus y equal to x. Let me put integral fy uy as fy dy as uy, integral gy dy as vy plus wx. So let us write the final solution. Z is equal to minus x cubed y cubed plus 1 by 4 cos 2x minus y plus xuy plus vy plus wx, where uy is equal to integral fy dy and vy is equal to integral gy dy. So that's the final solution. Next question. Solve dou square z by dou x dou y equal to sin x sin y, for which dou z by dou y equal to minus 2 sin y when x equal to 0 and z equal to 0 when y is an odd multiple of pi by 2. So here we are given two conditions. So the advantage of these two conditions is we can find the arbitrary function obtained in the integration procedure. So in the final answer, there won't be any arbitrary function. So those arbitrary functions can be identified with the help of the conditions given. So let us see how the procedure is applied here. Procedure is direct integration method. So we are going to solve this given equation solution. Now we are going to integrate the given equation with respect to y and with respect to x. So in the first integration, I am going to integrate the given function, the given PDE with respect to x. In this integration procedure, we keeping y as a constant, y as a temporary constant. Now, after this integration with respect to x, we will be having dou z by dou y equal to, we are keeping y as a constant, so sin y is a constant, integral cos x is integral sin x is minus cos x, plus there is a constant of integration. That constant of integration can be written as f of y. So this is minus cos x sin y plus f of y. Now let us apply our first condition here. What is the first condition? When x is equal to 0, dou z by dou x, dou z by dou y is equal to minus 2 sin y. Now I hope it is clear why I have integrated with respect to x first. Now, when we have integrated with respect to x, we got the resultant expression as dou z by dou y. So, in order to get this dou z by dou y, we have put the order of integration as first with respect to x, so that we can apply this condition. So, let us substitute x equal to 0 into this equation 1 and see what we have obtained. It is when x equal to 0, we have minus sin y plus f of y. And therefore, we will get our f of y as minus 2 sin y plus sin y. It is minus sin y. So, let me modify our equation 1. Let us modify our equation 1 as dou z by dou y equal to minus cos x sin y minus sin y. So let me put it as equation number 2. Now what is the next integration procedure? The next procedure is integration with respect to y. Now in this integration with respect to y, we have to keep x as a constant. So let us see what happens. So the left hand side, after integration with respect to y, it is z. In the right hand side, we have to keep minus cos x as a constant Integral sine y with respect to y is minus cos y. Then integral of minus sine y is plus cos y. Then we have a constant of integration. So let me put the constant of integration as gx. So this is the result of the second integration. We have z is equal to cos x cos y plus gx. So let me call this equation as equation number 3. Now we have the next condition that can be applied. When y is an odd multiple of, when y is an odd multiple of pi by 2, z equal to 0. So z equal to 0 as given in the condition, and from this equation 3, we have, after substituting y as an odd multiple of pi by 2, we will have cos y is equal to 0. So we have cos x into 0 plus the next term is cos y. Y is an odd multiple of pi by 2, so that cos y in the next term is also equal to 0 plus gx. So therefore you can see that gx is equal to 0. And then we have equation number 3 getting modified as z is equal to cos x cos y plus cos y. So that is the solution. That's our final answer. Z is equal to cos y into 1 plus cos x. So that's the answer to the second partial differential equation.